Hello and welcome to Driver's Habits. Many times we activate the AC system, but the air that comes from the fan is not enough or it smells bad. The most times that means that we have a bad cabin air filter we need to replace. But what happens when the vehicle is old and hasn't a cabin air filter? So in this video I'm going to show you how to clean in depth your ventilation system. First, we need to remove the bottom plastic trim on the passenger side. Then we need to remove the fan. We need to disconnect the fan's power connector, and before we remove the fan completely, we need to remove the side cover which is mounted to the dashboard. Then we need to remove completely the glove box. And we need to disconnect all the power connectors for the glove box light. Remove the fan power connector. And now we see the dirty fan. To remove the fan housing, I need to remove the side door trim. Remove the glove box top cover. And remove this small bar which supports the glove box cover. To remove the fan housing, you need to unscrew all the nuts or bolts. Then release the giant clamp and the housing is free. Remove the power connector and the cable. And here you can see the debris that comes from the outside. Before we clean this spot, I want to remove the evaporator bottom cover to clean it. So, disconnect the power connector and remove the clips. Remove completely the power connector and unscrew the nuts to release the bottom cover. This cover has two more clips on the back, but unfortunately there is not enough room to record it. After removing the clips, you can remove the bottom of the evaporator. And here you can see how a non-cabin air filter ventilation system looks like. Disgusting. I use a vacuum cleaner to remove all these disgusting things stuck to the evaporator. For the cleaning process, I use a soft hair brush because if you use any other tool, you're going to damage the fins of the evaporator. So, if you have the same problem, take your time and don't push the pipe on the fins. And this is how it looks like after a good cleaning. To clean the debris on top, we need to remove the windshield bottom cover. So, to remove it in this car, I need to remove the caps and unscrew all the bolts. To remove the windshield cover, you may need to remove the wiper arm. So, remove the cover and unscrew the nut. Push the arm and it's free. In my case, I removed only the passenger wiper and now I can pull the cover. The last cover has some clips you need to remove, but unfortunately the special tool for the clips doesn't fit, so I'm using two flat head screwdrivers. Now the cover is almost free. You need to remove this type of covers carefully because sometimes they have a rubber which sticks. Now we have enough room to clean the debris. So, again I'm using the vacuum cleaner, and I'm doing this because I don't want to blow this thing into the car or to my ventilation system. I just want to remove it. Also, I want to clean the cover, because it has a drain spot for the water. Now we can place the cover and the clips. Place the windshield cover. Screw the bolts and place the caps. Place the wiper arm. Tighten the nut. And place the cover. With a vacuum cleaner, I'm cleaning the evaporator cover and the fan. I'm removing the motor speed resistor to clean the fan housing with water. Now we have everything nice and clean. So, it's time to place the evaporator's bottom cover. Now it's time to place the clips. On top of the fan housing, there was a foamy rubber, so I want to remove it to place a new one. After removing the old rubber, clean the surface to prepare it for the new one. And then remove the excess. Place the motor speed resistor the fan the power connector and connect the power connector to the fan. For this model, there is no cabin air filter, so I decided to make my own air filter. I use a cooker hood air filter, which not reduce the airflow, and it's better than not having something to control what you're breathing into the cabin. And this is how it's going to be. In this spot, I'm rounding the corners because when the clamp fits, I don't want to fold the edges. Now the cabin air filter is ready, and we are ready to put everything back. Connect the cable and place the housing. Tighten all the nuts of the housing and place the clamp in the position. Connect the power connectors. And now you can check it. Now we are almost done. We need to place the small bar. The side cover. The lower dashboard cover with the power connectors. The dashboard side cover. The top cover for the glove box. The connectors for the glove box light. The glove box. And the last dashboard cover. And now we can check it. The fan works perfect. The airflow is better now than it was before. Even it has a custom air filter. Thanks for watching. I hope this video was helpful. If you like this video, remember to give it a thumbs up or share it, and follow me on Facebook, Twitter, Google+, Instagram, and if you're not a subscriber, click the subscribe button for more videos. Also, if you have any questions, leave a comment below.